Hello everyone, this is my Drama History ISU presentation, and my topic is going to be, well, it is woman suffrage. Now back in 1791, the only people who could vote were people who were considered people, and to be considered a person, you needed to own a certain amount of property or pay a certain amount of taxes. Now this person could even be a woman, and so what I'm trying to say is that women could vote back then. At the 1834 elections, there were actually several acts of violence that occurred, which resulted in three people dying. Now because of this, people thought that it wasn't safe for women to be out voting because it was so violent sometimes. And I'm just showing you here that people just thought it was unsafe for women to be voting. Now in 1840, the government caught on to these ideas and they basically said that women couldn't vote anymore. And what was resulted in this was that a lot of women were really angry because they wanted to vote too. And basically you'll see what happens next. Now basically what happened was, in 1883, Dr. Emily Stowe, she was Canada's first female doctor, she made this club that's called the Toronto Women's Literacy Club, but it wasn't actually a literacy club, it was for something else, and you'll find out what it is in a second. Now, the Toronto Women's Literacy Club wasn't actually a literacy club, it was actually a secret suffrage club, and Dr. Emily Stowe made this so that women all throughout Canada could meet up and talk about suffragist movements. Now eventually though, they changed the name and they actually called it the Toronto Women's Suffrage Association because it was like it was catching on, it was becoming a lot more popular, and because of this, so many other suffrage movements spread across Canada. And as you can see in this really beautiful drawing of Canada, suffragist movements were just spreading all across Canada, and the government was really starting to notice and they were really pressured to letting women have the right to vote. Now eventually, what happened was the government allowed women to vote in municipal elections, and which was a really good start, it was a really good beginning, but it just wasn't enough, and a lot of the women wanted to move on and try to get the provincial vote now, because since it got the municipal vote, they thought it was going to be easier to get the provincial vote. So what they did was, in 1905, they introduced a vote for suffrage. When it was introduced, everybody started laughing at it, and they were saying insults, and they just treated it as a joke. When they did it again the next year, 1906, people had the same response. People were laughing, people were like throwing insults at them, and it just wasn't that great. But the women, they kept on trying year after year after year, and as you can see, from 1907 to 1916, they tried and they all ended up the same way. But the women kept on trying and they just didn't stop until they got it. And in 1917, almost all the provinces gave women the right to vote in provincial elections. The first one was Ontario, the second one was Montreal, then eventually they all caught on, except Quebec. Then in 1918, women could vote in federal elections, and in 1919, women could even run for federal office. This was a big step for everyone, and in 1921, that was the first election men and women could run if they were 21 and over and had citizenship. Now this made everybody really happy, but not for long. Because Quebec didn't have the didn't give women the right to vote in provincial elections, only 90% of the voters were registered compared to the 99% in Ontario. But in 1940, Quebec finally gave women the right to vote in the provincial elections, and this made everybody really happy. Well, the majority of people. There was still a minority who didn't have the vote, but they were working really hard to get it. And in 1960, after a lot of fighting, minority groups finally got the right to vote. As you can see, from the 1700s to the mid-1900s, the history of women's suffrage was like a roller coaster ride. But now, all women in Canada can vote if you're over a certain age and have your citizenship. So everything's good.